Hello friends, welcome to this video on CAT 2019 solving. In this video, we'll cover questions from equations, which is part of algebra. There were 8 questions asked across 2 slots in CAT 2019 from equations. We'll solve all the questions. So let's start solving. So the first question was the number of solutions of this particular equation with you. Now, you see, the first thing which you observe here is that we have modulus of x. Okay. So we have to take 2 cases. Okay. So if we solve first case, we can write x as it is. Okay. So write 6x cube plus x is equal to 5x square. 6x cube minus 5x square plus x is equal to 0. We take x common, we'll get 6x square plus minus 5x plus 1. This is equal to 0. 6 into 1, 6, we can split it in minus 2x and minus 3x. So we'll write it as 6x square minus 2x minus 3x plus 1. X multiplied with x, we take 3x minus 1 common, okay, you will get 2x minus 1 equal to 0. So the values of x are 0, then 1 by 3 and 1 by 2. We have assumed here that x is greater than or equal to 0. So all 3 are satisfying this condition. So it's fine. Okay, x is actually greater than 0 here in the solution as well. Okay. So second case, this is case 1. Case 2. Case 2 will take x less than 0. Okay, so we'll write negative sign. Okay, so I'll write it's minus 6x cube. Then minus x is equal to 5x square. We'll take everything on the right hand side. So we can write 6x square plus 5x square plus x equal to 0. Now here, if you see, it's quite it's same, almost same. That means instead of this minus, we have plus. So I can directly write it as 3x plus 1 into 2x plus 1 equal to 0. So values of x are 0, minus 1 by 3 and minus 1 by 2. Now we are asked number of solutions. Okay, so number of solutions are 1, 2, 3, x equal to 0 is already there, 4, and 5. So number of solution of this question is 5. So answer will be 5. Okay, so basic funda of means modulus, understanding of modulus is required. Otherwise, simple steps were to be taken. Okay. Now let's solve next question. Okay, question number 2, the product of distinct roots of this particular equation. Again, we have modulus, so we have to apply the same funda. We will have 2 cases. Okay, one case is when, so we'll write case 1, this is greater than 0. If you see, the solutions will be minus 2 and 3, so our x should be greater than 3, greater than equal to, or less than equal to minus 2. Okay, and we have to try to find product of all the distinct roots of this particular case. Okay, so I'll write as it is in the first case, minus 6 is equal to x plus 2, x squared minus 2x minus 8 is equal to 0. We'll get x minus 4 into x plus 2. 8 can be split into minus 4 into 2. Okay, so x is equal to 4 and minus 2. Both these are satisfying the conditions. Okay, so these are valid roots. Okay, x should be greater than 3 and x should be less than or equal to minus 2. Both are satisfied. Okay. Next, case 2. This should be less than 0. Okay, so now our x should be between minus 2 to 3. Now, we'll again apply the same thing. This time we have to take it as negative. We could have written right inside as negative. Okay, that would have solved the problem as well, but no problem. If you see, you will have x square is equal to 4. X is equal to plus minus 2. So plus 2 again lies between minus 2 and 3. Minus 2 again lies in the same value. Okay. So we have, we can write it as 2 and minus 2. Now the question is product of distinct roots of this particular equation. Okay, so 4 is there, minus 2 is there, 2 is there, minus 2 is repeated, so we are not supposed to count it. So the answer will be 4 into minus 2 into 2, which is equal to minus 16. Option 2. So simple application of Honda of modulus. And we could just find the roots. Okay, so nothing extra was required. Okay, let's solve question number 3. Now this particular question reminds me of when you see this particular part, 2 power x plus 2 power minus x. Okay, this is nothing but a plus 1 by a or x plus 1 by x. Now we know that the minimum value of this, okay, is 2. Okay, and since 2 is positive, so that is means a is positive, okay, 2 power x, so that is the minimum value we can get. We have on the left hand side 2 into this number, cos of something. Cos lies between minus 1 and 1. That means it can take value 2, this left hand side can take value from minus 2 to 2. Right hand side can take values from 2 or more than 2. That means the only case when it will satisfy the condition is when both are equal to 2. So I can write right hand, left hand side is equal to 2. When this will happen, when x is equal to 0. That is the only case which when it can happen. Is there any other way it is possible? Okay, if you see this one, cos can be 0 when x is equal to 0 or minus 1. But in that case, this won't be true. So only case when it's possible that left hand side and right hand side are equal to 2 when x is equal to 0. There's no other solution possible. So answer of this question is number of solutions is only 1, which is 2. So rather than solving equation, it was totally about common sense. Okay, one thing which we are supposed to know, understanding of cos theta. Another was knowing this a plus 1 by a. This is something which is you means this particular concept is used numerous time in CAT. Okay, that you are given something in form a plus a and you have to just think about it, that think that the minimum value it can take is 2. And that is the only the application which you are supposed to apply and get this one answer. Let's see question number 4. This question number 4 is similar to, I remember there was a question, okay, once asked in CAT, which was something like this. Okay, I don't remember the formula, but then something like this, that we are given a0, we are means n, so a, sorry, a n plus 1, a n, something like this was given. So this particular question also follows the same. Okay. What we are given is the initial value is p, then we are getting 3 plus 2p, then it will become twice of this, which is 4p plus 6 plus 3, so it will become 9. Then if you multiply again with 2 and add 3, so 8p into 2, 18 plus 3, 20. So this is how we are supposed to do it. It means this is what is given again. Now, if you remember that particular question, there are two ways we can solve it. One is we can use a GP, okay, to solve this question. Okay, so I'll first of all use that method. Okay, secondly, we can simply see what can be the general term and solve it again. So let's start. So in second term, we will use options. Okay, so first term, okay, so we have P, second term, we have 3 plus 2P. This can be written as I write multiplying 2, so 2 square into p, multiplying 2, so 3 into 2 plus 3. Next term will be 2 power 3 p, 3 into 2 square into 3 into 2 plus 3, and this is how it will go on. Okay, now we have started in 2019. Okay, we are going till 2034. So this is the first term. Okay, so we are going to the 16th term, 19 to 36, so 16th term. So first term, second term, third term, 16th term. So we should have something like this. General formula should be 2 power 16 into p plus, so it's not 16, one lesser. Okay, for p it was p. Okay, for second term it was 2p, for third term it was power was 2, so one lesser, so into 2 power 15 into p, 3 into 2 power 14, and so on till one. This is a GP. If we add the terms, we'll get 3 into 2 power 15 minus 1, 2 minus 1. So this is what we have decided. Now, so let's take, okay. So this is 3 into 2 power 15 minus 1. Denominator is 2 minus 1, which is 1. Okay. So I can write this as the whole thing as. So I can write this whole thing as 2 power 15 into p plus 3 and 3 into this minus 3. Since p here is given as 1000, so answer would be 1003 2 power 15 minus 3, which is option 4. Okay, now let's see alternate way to solve this again. Now if we look at the options again, we had p is equal to 1000 and these are the values again. Now since this 2034 is term number 16, so I'm writing generalizing form. Okay, so I'm writing this should be 1000 minus 3, okay, into 2 power n minus 2 plus 3. Okay, this can be written as, okay, 1000 minus 3, 2 power n minus 1 minus 3. This is general formula of 1003 power 15 plus 6, and the last one is, so not 16, okay, minus 6, 2 power, so n minus 1 plus 6, okay. And the last one is 1003 into 2 power n minus 1 minus 2. So first one is p, second one if you see should be 2003. Okay, which of these following it? Okay, if I write n equal to 2, this will give me 1003 minus 3 997 plus 3 1000, which is not correct. I have to put n equal to 2, and this is n equal to 1, this is n equal to 2. So if I put n equal to 2 here, I'll get 0, so 2 power 0 is 1. So this number is 997 plus 3 1000, which is not satisfying. Secondly, if I put 2 here, I'll get 2 power 1. 2 power 1 is 2. If you multiply 997 minus 3, 997 into 2 minus 3, that is also not equal to 2003. So this is also incorrect. Okay. This one is going into 1003 power 1 plus 6, which is 1009, not equal to this number. The last one is the only case where we have the same number as 2000. Means double of this is 2006 minus 3, 2003. So this is the case which is satisfying it. So there are two ways we can solve it. Okay, but it's very important you remember the concept which we have used in solving previous year questions. Same things are applicable here as well. Okay. Question number 5. This particular quadratic equation has two roots, and where a is an integer, which of the following is possible value of b square plus c? So roots are 4a and 3a, so I can directly write x square minus 7ax plus 12a square. This is what we can write. B square plus c. B square plus c means 7a square, so which is 49a square plus 12a square. This is 61a square. So this should be, this is the value which we are looking for. Now, which of the following is possible? So we need a multiple of 61. Is it a multiple of 61? If you divide 549 by 61, we'll get 9. 61 into 9 is a square. Okay, so this is the answer we are looking for. Okay. Question, if you see option 3 is also satisfying, divisible by 67, 1, but we are getting 7. 61 into 7. 7 is not a square. A and a is an integer. Okay, so perfect, a 7 is not a perfect square. So that's why answer is option 1. Very easy question. Okay. Question number 6. Again, simple application, okay, of quadratic equation. What we are supposed to do here is we are supposed to write 2 power 3 x as a variable y, and we are changing this equation. We'll get y square. 2 power 3 x is y, so this will become 4 into y minus 21 equal to 0. We have to split 21 and we should get sum as 4, so that is 7 into minus 3. So I write y plus 7 into y minus 3. So y is equal to minus 7 or y is equal to 3. Now we are asked real root. Okay, y is equal to means these are the two conditions given. 2 power 3x is equal to minus 7, which is not possible, so this is not a real root. Second case is 2 power 3x is equal to 3. If we apply log 2, we will get 3x is equal to log base 2, 3. But still we don't have value of x. X is equal to how much? Log base 2, 3 divided by 3. So this is the answer we were looking for, which is option 1. So simple, we have to use two things here. We have to just change the equation, and second thing is we have to apply log here. Let's solve next question. Okay, this is a very easy question. This doesn't need any solving. Okay, you have to just remember certain things. Okay, so we are given a square plus b square is equal to 25. This should ring some bell. Okay, which is, if you remember, a square plus b square is 25 is 3 square plus 4 means 3 square plus 4 square is equal to 5 square. Okay, so that is something you can remember. Okay, this is also 5 square plus 12 square is equal to 13 square. But we are given ax plus by is equal to 65. Now, ax plus by is equal to 65 means we need 13 into 5. So rather than writing in this form, what we can do is we can write this as 5 square plus 0 square. And also we can write 13 square plus 0 square. So what we can do is we can write either a or b as 5. Okay, so if I'm writing a as 5, then I can have to get x equal to 30. In that case, b is equal to 0 and y is equal to 0. That is one of the case which is possible, okay, which is satisfying all three equations. Okay, 5 square plus 0 square is 25, 13 square plus 0 square is 169, ax plus by, 5 into 13 is 65. So that is a common sense which we can use. Okay, now we are asked this, what is the value of k? Okay, or k, we have to know something about k. So k is, in this particular case, k is equal to how much? 0. So our answer should satisfy this condition, k is equal to 0. Okay, so obviously option 1 is not possible. Option 2, we are getting one case. Okay, so this is possible. Okay, option 3 is saying k is greater than 5 by 13, but our k which we are getting as a solution, okay, which that is not greater than 5 by 3. Fourth case is saying k is between 0 and 5 by 13 and 0 is not possible, but means we have found a solution with k is equal to 0. That means this is the only solution possible. So we had to just look for this particular case and we could solve the question. So remember these small things. Okay, so although we did not use Pythagorean triplet, okay, but then that should ring some bells. When you see 25, you should always remember 5 square. When you see 169, you should remember 13 square. Now solve question number 8. Roots of this equation are real and distinct. Okay, so that means d is greater than equal to greater than distinct, so greater than 0, so not equal to. Okay, so only greater than 0, so that is the condition we have. Okay, so like b square, which is 16 minus 4 into 1 into minus log 2 base 2 is greater than 0. So 16 plus 4 log 2a, so I can write it as this is greater than 0, so log base 2a is greater than 16 by 4, which is minus 4. So this is the condition we have. So what we'll do is we'll change this. Okay, we'll write 2 power. Okay, so 2 power this number will give us minus 4. Sorry, this will give us a, and this is 2 power minus 4. So a is greater than 1 by 16, which is option 4. So that is the answer. Okay, so one thing which I always means I feel is in from the topic equations, we get always predictable questions, as in questions which have been asked in CAT before. Okay, so what you need to do is, okay, you have to revise previous year questions, okay, and then remember the basic fundamentals. If you do that, you should be able to solve all the questions which are asked. Okay, so all the four questions in each of the slots, okay, were solvable within 2 to 3 minutes max. Some of the questions where you could, as we have seen, could have been solved within a minute also. So that is all. Thank you very much.